We are here at the National Curriculum Development Center to talk to Mr. Muganga Christopher, a curriculum specialist, about the new curriculum that has been rolled out in the O-level secondary schools. Good evening, Mr. Muganga. The Ministry of Education rolled out a new curriculum at the O-level in 2020. What is this new curriculum?
Okay, new curriculum, we have three types of assessment. There's what we call classroom-based assessment. On a daily basis, a teacher is teaching the learners and is assessing learners visually, looking at them, is assessing learners by conversing with them and puts them on a task to explain why is it difficult, why can't you do it, what is the problem. And you can even assess the learners when they have done something, what we call the product, either writing an essay, drawing something, a map. Now, that one is not for marks. It is for learning, and it is called formative classroom assessment. Now, we have another assessment, again in the school, which is like the end of term. But this time round in the new curriculum, it is not end of term. It is when you finish the topic. So, depending on the time you have taken to finish the topic, that is your end of term. Every time you finish the topic, you do that assessment. And by the time the term ends, they just gather how many topics have you finished in that term. They enter them in the report. So, there is no end of term tests. That one is called school-based summative assessment. Those are the ones which are going to be sent to UNEB, those scores from the topics you have scored, so that they contribute 20% of your senior four.
This week we saw UNEB and NERA coming out to say that they are going to be issuing national IDs to all students on this new curriculum. How is the national ID connected to the assessment in the new curriculum?
Because we have to follow you, the learner, from the beginning up to the end. Because the teacher will be scoring you and sending your marks or your scores to the portal. Now that the UNEB will not have a register. They will just have a portal which is digital. That the schools are posting all these learners' performances, meaning you must have a number to identify your collections in the course of your stay in the school. So that number is going to be correlating that even if you move away from this school and you change school and you go to another school, it is easy to follow up your register because it is digital. You just reach where you are going, you tell those people your number, they are going to look for your number where it is, and you start again accumulating your marks. That is the correlation.
Why isn't the shift in curriculums from the old one to the new one accommodative of students that were supposed to repeat in senior three this year?
The two methods of learning are different. So these ones who are in senior three last year, if they are made to repeat, they will have challenges of coping up with the new learning approach. Because for them, their alignment is in the old structure of writing notes, the way the teacher gave it to you, cramming ideas, presenting the same points. Yet the new curriculum doesn't call for that.
Won't this lead to half-baked students along the way?
Now, the new curriculum is looking for the learner presenting his or her own ideas from what he has learned. The old curriculum is presenting what you were given. So the two can't work. The methods are different. That these ones who are coming from senior to now, they manage their own learning even if the teacher is not there.
In the new curriculum, it is learner-centered, and in the old curriculum, it was teacher-centered. Thank you very much for watching us this week.